Welcome to the College of Lake County Canvas overview. So when we first log into Canvas, we arrive on the dashboard. The dashboard is where we can see our course cards. So you see I'm in a training course and Introduction to Network and also CLC Passport to Canvas. So this is the dashboard, and these are the courses that it's currently showing for me. You'll see on the right, I also have the to-do list, which gives me an opportunity to see some upcoming assignments that'll be due for me, for example. And then over here, I have what's called the kebab, these three dots in a row. And if I click there, I have an opportunity to change my dashboard view. So right now I'm in card view, but I could change that to list view if I liked that better, where I can see the days that are coming up. I can see some activity up here from one of my courses. This was an announcement in one of my courses. I can go back to that kebab, those three dots, and I can change to a different view of the dashboard, which is just recent activities. So here's six different assignment notifications from one of my courses, and I can drop this down and see those individual assignments and link directly to them. And then if I want to change that back to the card view, which is where I like it, I can just click that kebab and click card view, and here are my cards for my different courses. The other thing to notice here is that some of the courses where there's been some activity, I have these icons on the course card that will take me directly to assignments or the discussion board or the files area of this particular course. So over here, this course has an announcement. So I could click right there and it would take me to that course's announcement. So that's all available on those course cards. The other thing very quickly is there's a kebab on each course card that would allow you to customize the color as well as the nickname of that course. So you have the capability to do that. You also have the capability to click and drag the course cards and rearrange them in any way you want them to look on your Canvas dashboard. So let's take a look at, on the left-hand side, this is called global navigation in Canvas. So these are the menu buttons that everyone in Canvas can see. So the first one is the account button. So I'm going to click there, and this will slide out, and I'll get some different options. And there are some important things for you to look at here. The first is the notifications. So if I click on notifications, this will show all the different ways that Canvas can contact me about events in my courses. So everyone by default will have a single column, which is an email address. And then if you log into our Canvas instance with the Canvas student app, you'll also get this column for push notifications. And what you see is you have all these different activities and discussions, and conversations is also known as the Canvas inbox, scheduling things, alerts, all of these, you're able to say how often and what type of notification should there be. So for example, when a due date is updated, I can find out via email either right away, a daily summary, a weekly summary, or don't notify me. And then with the push notification, which again is through your mobile device and the Canvas student app, I can either be notified right away or not notified at all. So you have control over all of these different notifications, which lets you say, how should Canvas contact you? Next is the profile on the left. This is where you can add a picture of yourself, which helps very much in engaging with other students and with your faculty member. And you'll have the ability to do some simple updates to this profile with the Edit Profile button. Also on the left, you'll see there's Settings. So if I click on Settings, this is a way that I'm actually able to add other ways to contact. So right now, there's an email address in here. Additionally, you'll automatically get your college email address, your CLC email address will automatically be part of your profile. But if you have a personal email address that you'd also like to be contacted, you can add that in here. Certainly, downloading the Canvas mobile app would be a great way to be contacted. You can also utilize SMS messages. However, at this time, it appears that Canvas is moving away from doing texting and moving more towards doing push notifications. And lastly, because this is something new, you have the ability to use this QR code for mobile login. And so the way that works is after I've logged into Canvas, I can go to this page. And then if I get my mobile device with the Canvas student mobile app, instead of having to find College of Lake County's Canvas instance and logging in, I can actually just open that student app, click on login via QR code, and it will use this QR code and log me in directly. And I really only have to do that once. It really just makes the login process on your mobile device much quicker and easier. And then I have a button called Courses. And so that slides out. The difference between the dashboard and Courses initially is they're pretty much the same. But what will happen as you spend more time taking courses at CLC and taking courses in Canvas is there may be courses that are historical that you've already taken from a previous semester. So those will always be available through this courses menu and through this all courses link. So if I click on all courses, you see it shows me all the courses that I'm connected to as a student. And they have this star on the left-hand side. So if I clicked one of these stars, it would then include that course in my dashboard. So you'll see now there's another course included in my dashboard. So you have the ability to unfavorite some of those courses. So I'll undo that because that maybe was a course from a previous semester or a course I'm no longer taking. Perhaps it's even ended if it was a shorter course. So now I just want the courses that I need to see be a part of my Canvas dashboard. Next is the calendar. The calendar is a great way to see what's happening for you in Canvas. And you'll notice I have these three events that are already a part of my calendar, and I can tell by color that they're part of this Cisco Introduction to Network course. Because if I click that square with that same color, those courses disappear. What you'll notice is if you're enrolled in multiple courses, the different important dates for your courses will show up together on this calendar. And again, you can look at it by week or by month, or even by agenda, which is like a list of what's coming up. And then these individual assignments will link to those assignments in the course. But you have the ability, as I showed you, to take off a certain course so you can just focus on a given calendar. You also have the ability to click on the kebab over here next to this particular course calendar, and maybe I want to change the color that those courses appear in, so I can simply change that color and it'll show me that class in that color. So you have a little bit of customization there. And there's also the ability to get a calendar feed from your Canvas calendar. So for example, if I wanted to see what all my course assignments and dates were from Canvas, but I wanted to put that on my mobile device, I can use this in a Google Calendar or Outlook or whichever. But this, just to keep it clear, this is information coming from Canvas to your calendar. So it doesn't go the other way. You can input events on your Canvas calendar, but the feed only comes as a subscription. So it shows you your Canvas calendar within your other calendaring app. Next is the inbox. The inbox is a way to do internal email with your instructor. So your instructor can use this, or you can contact your instructor via this tool. If you click right up here, you can create a message. So I could just select a course that I wanted to send a message to and who I wanted to send that message to, a subject. I can even attach. And the nice thing is that this will can go directly to your faculty member. And that email, if someone contacts you through the Canvas inbox, it will go here inside of Canvas, but it will also go to your student email. So you would see that in your Gmail from CLC, but you would also see it here inside of Canvas. So you can manage that messaging in both places. And lastly, there's the help menu in the global navigation. The help menu is a big one. You have Canvas guides, which are full of help about Canvas, and those are specific to you as a student. There's a link to our online student success resources here. You can ask an instructor a question, which actually just uses that inbox that we just looked at. And here's the two that I think are very important: the chat with Canvas student support and the Canvas support hotline for students. These are 24/7 contact methods for you if you have any questions while you're using Canvas, if you're stuck on something or how to find something or how to do something in Canvas. So I'm going to go back to my dashboard because I want to get into a course. So I'm going to click on the Passport to Canvas course. And so now you'll see that I have an additional menu here on the left. That's called the course menu. I have my main course content here in the middle, and then I have some options, including to-dos and recent feedback on the right-hand column as part of my course. So the page we arrive on is known as the course homepage. That can be a custom page like it is here, introducing the course. It could also be a link to some other course parts in Canvas, such as the modules page. We'll look at that here next. So if I click on modules, modules are basically the map to courses within Canvas. So they're usually done by topic or by week, but then these are links to the different material that makes up this course. So for example, the first thing I can click on is this page about earning by learning in the introduction module. So if I click on that, it'll show me that information and I can read through there. And then I have this next button at the bottom. So that next button actually takes me into the first module and it shows me the first piece of content from that module. So I can read about that and figure out what is in there for me to do. And then I can simply click next after I'm done and it'll take me to the next part and show me that information. So you can move through here very linearly. So here they're talking about the dashboard again, which we talked about earlier. You can also use the previous button to go back a page and see what I had previously read. I'm going to go back to my dashboard. And over here on the right, I can see I have some assignments that are in my to-do list. So if I just clicked on this assignment, it will show me the instructions of this assignment. So this is an assignment in computer networking, so I won't bore you with all of these details. But if I had either my file that I was putting together or I wanted to just answer this assignment by typing out an answer, I go to that assignment and I click here on Submit Assignment, and you'll see it gives me some options, including the ability to upload a file or to enter some text that will then submit my answer to that assignment. So back on the dashboard, I want to show you one more thing, and that's when I want to log out of Canvas. So I would click on Account, and I have a logout button right there, and that logs me completely out of the Canvas system. So that's a very short overview of Canvas, but hopefully a good way to get you started. I would encourage you to try the Passport to Canvas course, which is a self-paced course that will allow you to walk through all the different parts of Canvas as a student. Thank you.